Okay, hold up right there.
If you want to understand the dynamics and complexities of a marsh, you've got to dig into it.
All right. So we are about 60 centimeters inside. And 59, almost 60 outside. So we're looking good.
That's why these researchers from Chowan University are taking core samples in the tall grass of Currituck Sound. Currituck Sound is about 3 miles wide and roughly 42 miles long. It stretches from around Kitty Hawk at the south end to Back Bay and the Virginia border at the north. It's a large body of water, but it's not very deep. The depth ranges from 1 to 3 feet. But what makes this jewel of the Outer Banks so unique is that its only connection to the ocean is far south at Oregon Inlet. So, with so little contact with the ocean, Currituck Sound is essentially filled with fresh water.
It is. It's very different. Most of the sounds in North Carolina are brackish. They have a higher level of salt. Currituck Sound has a low level of salt and is in essence a nearly fresh estuary. So that makes the dynamics very different here. We also have very few major rivers flowing in. Well, really no major rivers. We have very small rivers flowing in. And so we don't get that big pulse of sediment that major rivers put into it.
Currituck Sound is even more unique because it is not a tidal estuary. Trouble is, that lack of tidal action means there is a serious erosion problem that is destroying the marshes around the sound. And those marshes provide critical habitat for waterfowl, breeding grounds for fish, and protection from storms.
Most of the time when you think of the tide at the beach, you think of lunar tide. Yeah, the high tide comes in, low tide goes out twice a day, regularly as clockwork. Here, we're entirely dominated by wind tides. So there's a very, very tiny fraction of tidal change, which is lunar. It's all depending on if the wind's coming from the northeast, then all this water gets pushed down into the lower sounds. If the wind's coming from the southwest, it pushes all this water up into the sound. And so that changes the dynamics of the sound on a regular basis. These big southwesters, along with sea level rise, are inundating and eroding away these marshes. Currituck Sound loses 72 acres of marsh every single year to erosion.
The challenges facing Currituck Sound from sea level rise are pretty clear when you see the dock at Audubon's Pine Island Sanctuary. The dock was built around 1913 as part of a hunt club. That section at water level is the original dock. The higher section was recently added. It's an indication of just how sea level rise is affecting the sound.
Here we go. On three, real slow. 1, 2, 3. You just make sure nothing falls out the bottom, that's it.
Which brings us back to the core samples those researchers are taking from the marshes on Currituck Sound. Ironically, for as large and as unique as the sound is, not much is known about it. So, North Carolina Sea Grant is helping to fund a study of the sound, which will create a detailed habitat map of the area, as well as look at how the marsh is coping with rising sea levels.
You see a lot of the fibrous root, fine root matter in here, okay? And this dark is sediment. It's really clay and silt. And so the way, in general, the processes that a marsh will maintain its elevation with sea level rise is the accumulation of organic matter, which you're seeing here, both organic material from the surface as well as root matter beneath the surface. And sediment that is brought onto the marsh surface through storm events and flooding. And so our project is trying to quantify that. The way a marsh surface decreases in elevation is through erosion and decomposition. So this organic matter will break down over time due to bacteria and invertebrates and things like that.
The study is also surveying what plants make up the marsh.
But here's a stem, and I think you might be able to see that it's hollow. There is a special tissue called parenchyma, and it's just filled with holes. And that allows diffusion from the surface into the root systems, because oxygen will diffuse much faster in air than it does in water. So wetland plants typically have very spongy, hollow stems.
I am taking a vegetation plot. And so what I'll be doing is cutting the grass stalks and then collecting them, and then plant matter, the plant litter that's only in this plot.
Researchers want to know if rising seas will speed up erosion in the marshes, and whether the marshes in Currituck Sound will be able to grow fast enough to keep up with rising seas.
So with climate change, there are predictions of sea level rise in this area in the next 30 years or so, can range from a half a foot to a foot.
So our goal is to see what we can do, really understand the marshes, and then start to begin to understand how we can help the marshes help themselves.